online right now, as some reports indicating that the incident happened near the Old City of Jerusalem Al-Quds. Two of those victims have been seriously injured. So for those of you who are just joining us, at least 15 people have been injured by a truck ramming into pedestrians in Jerusalem. Al-Quds ramming into a crowd. Two of those injured in the truck ramming attack are in critical condition. The death toll stands now at four. Those in critical condition could add to the death toll count. Of course, we're keeping a close eye on all the details surrounding this truck ramming incident in Jerusalem Al-Quds. Israeli media are stating right now that at least four people have been killed in the alleged truck ramming attack in Jerusalem Al-Quds. Of course, as we mentioned, this is a developing story, so all the details are murky at this point. We are trying to keep you up to date as best we can. According to Israeli security forces, over a dozen people were injured in what they called a deliberate attack. The driver of the truck has been shot. So the alleged truck ramming has killed four in occupied Al-Quds. I'm being told that we're now being joined by our correspondent. Mona Candil is with us from Ramallah to bring us up to speed on what has taken place in occupied Al-Quds. Mona, what details do you have to share with us with regards to this alleged truck ramming attack?
Well, just now the Israeli military is saying that a Palestinian man was driving this truck and that he, as you have mentioned, stormed the bus station in Jerusalem Al-Quds, and he is he's a Palestinian resident of Jerusalem Al-Quds, and then he hit a number of Israeli soldiers who were waiting at the bus station in order to enter the buses or get military buses. At least 15 Israeli soldiers were wounded. We're speaking about four Israeli soldiers killed. The three others are in very serious condition. And immediately, the Israeli forces that are in the area opened fire at this Palestinian man and killed him immediately. Up till the moment, it's not clear. The Palestinian Ministry of Health didn't say or reveal that this is a Palestinian man who carried out, according to the Israelis, anti-Israeli attack, or that if he really was his punctual while driving his vehicle. The Israeli forces are insisting that it's another attack by a Palestinian inside the Jerusalem Al-Quds, near one of the well-known Israeli settlements there. So no doubt it's impossible, according to them, for a Palestinian to enter these areas because he wants to carry out a attack or something. Now, all the area has been closed off to traffic in all directions. The Israeli forces, as always and as we expect, will be checking the Palestinian vehicles, their IDs. They would be, of course, going to arrest Palestinian youths in the Arab neighborhoods of Jerusalem Al-Quds and all the areas that surrounding Jerusalem Al-Quds from the occupied West Bank, of course, would be closed, and Palestinians were not allowed to enter Jerusalem or leave it, at least to know the identity of this Palestinian who carried out, according to the Israelis, anti-Israeli operation. Until the identity of this man is revealed, the Israelis would continue searching, carrying out their strict measures until the identity would be known.
All right, thank you very much. Press News, Mona Candil joining us from Ramallah. Let's just put together what we have learned by talking to our correspondent right now. A Palestinian man who was driving a truck allegedly rammed into a bus station that was filled with Israeli soldiers. Four of those Israeli soldiers have been killed. 15 have been injured. The Palestinian man was shot and killed immediately, and Israeli forces have closed off the area. Of course, we'll keep you posted on all the details of this story and much more as we get it for you right here on Press TV. A British